Hello and welcome to the show. On today's episode, we've got the brilliant Becky James, who's going to be showing us an upcycled project using the 12 Days of Christmas Paper Mania collection to create a beautiful little Christmas decoration. But before we get to that, I just wanted to show you these lovely wine glass projects, also by Becky James, and they feature in Creativity magazine, the September issue, so make sure you check them out. And they've got these beautiful little scenes, and it's just a simple wine glass, and you've got a lovely little die-cut gingerbread man using the X-cut medley set, and a lovely little house. So make sure you have a go and check out that issue of the magazine. Hi Becky, welcome to the show.
Hi Sarah, lovely to be here today.
So what have you got for us today?
Well, today we're going to make this little, it's actually a countdown sort of 12 days of Christmas yep. clock because it's got the clock face on it. But really, it's an upcycled project using a tin. So I'm going to show you how
that all goes together.
We've got, it's actually a travel suite tin. Everybody's got these sort of things floating around at home. I've got a bucket load of them, so I'm really pleased to be showing you a nice project using those today.
Good excuse to eat sweets.
Absolutely, there is never a bad excuse to eat sweets. So what I've done already with this one is I've covered it. Now I've covered the inside as well, so it's nicely finished off on the outside. I've used the 12 Days of Christmas 12 by 12 papers because what I've actually done as well is they've have a few of the papers are nicely cut into quarters with one of each of the 12 days designs on there. So if you're doing an 8x8 inch card or something, they're perfect toppers. But I've actually used one of those on the back. But if you want to, you can just use a pattern paper, a matching pattern paper. But I just thought that was a nice touch.
Yeah, you've got lovely little sentiments and phrases on there.
Absolutely,
as well.
Yeah, they're really lovely. It's a really lovely range. And I've already put in here layered up foam dots because when I put my centrepiece into this, it'll just lift it up more towards the front of the tin. So we're going to carry on and make that. Now, this actually uses the 12 Days of Christmas easel card and the decoupage in that, and also some of the 8x8 inch medley as well. So we're going to start with this. And as you can see, if I just put that together, it actually starts off as quite an oval design. And this is one of the great things about decoupage or toppers or things like that, is you can actually die cut out what you want. And I want that design fits lovely in the tin. So I've just die cut it out.
Oh, that's a gorgeous little scene, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. So I've just die cut that out, leave that to one side. And I've given it a kind of a nice vintagey feel with a little bit of chocolate ink on everything, artiste chocolate ink. Now what I've already done here is I've layered up the other layers within the easel card decoupage. To do that, what I actually did was I took, because it's quite a big design, if we just go back to this bit, because it's quite a big design, it's very easy for me to layer that on top of the next layer, draw around it, and then layer things up that way. Okay. So it was really, really easy to do that. And we did that, and then I've put a frame around the outside as well. So what I've done is I've already put the backing on here, and we're just going to add these last little layers.
Okay.
So now just a little tip, because I've got lots of foam on there so that it's nice and sturdy, but what I want to do is just put some glue stick over the top of these foam dots.
So does that make it extra strong?
No, what it actually does is it means that if I don't get it in quite the right place, so say I've got it a little bit out of kilter, I can actually move it around for a little bit.
I see.
But once that glue dries, you actually have the lovely permanency of the foam dots and everything. So it works with double-sided tape as well.
Especially it helps the decoupage when you do want to get it so precise.
Yeah, exactly. That's it. So what I'm doing is just taking all the foam dots out of there. And again, just get my glue stick. And just put that over the top there. Well used glue stick, that one. Now then, what I need to do is make sure I'm looking on the back. That's the top. So I'll pop that in line, and all we're going to do is drop it in. You might have to just grab hold of the centre, but drop it in there and push down. And there we go.
It reminds me of a little alarm clock or something you put on your bedside table.
Absolutely. Now I've also got some bits of the icons here, so you can see the little swans, the little sentiment, snowflake. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually add these onto here. Oh, I'll just get my glue gun.
And this is from the card kit then as well.
These are all from the card kit. Yeah, that's it. There is so much in there. There really is. So if I just show you, I've put all the little decorations in the centre there, and all, as I say, there's all those little lovely icons.
Gorgeous.
And I'm just going to add a few little crystals before we move on.
Yeah, well, you need a bit of sparkle at Christmas.
You do. And this, actually, this range, the colours in this range, really work well, both with a bit of sparkle, but also that vintage feel as well.
You
can really play around with them. So there we go. So that's the inside of the tin. Complete.
Lovely.
How easy was that?
That was really simple.
Not difficult, was it?
I think Evergreen could definitely have a go at that project.
Yeah, absolutely. So the next thing we're going to do is add some feet on the bottom because we want it to stand up, and obviously at the moment it's going to rock all over the place. So what I've got here are some beads out of the Craft Planet wooden bead set. Right, so all I'm going to do, just pop a blob down towards the bottom where I want it, my feet to be, a blob of hot melt glue, stick the bead in, have another look, try and get it somewhere pretty much centrally to that, pop that one there. If you're not certain whether you're going to get it central, have a look at it, make some marks,
okay.
and then go from there.
Yeah.
And then I'm just putting one extra one at the back because that's all it needs, but you can put another two at the back if you want.
I guess if you wanted to, you could even hang it up, couldn't you, as on the tree or
absolutely.
From a door.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, there we go. Let me just... That's it. So now it stands up. Perfect. Oh. Next little thing that we're going to add, and this is actually, let's show you. These are the little Paper Mania clock faces and clock hands. I love these. They have beautiful either coppery or gold tones or the silver, which I've chosen here to go with this project. But these are really lovely. And I kind of thought about when it said 12 Days of Christmas, I was thinking, oh, clock face, you know, 12 days. So you can either, you don't have to use it, but if you want to, you can count down the 12 days. Blob of glue on the back, and that'll stick that in place there. So you've got your...
That's lovely.
Right. So the final little touches, I'm just going to show you how to add a few of the snowflakes. But the dye that I've actually used for this is this snowflake dye. And then all I'm doing is just tucking them underneath each other so you get a kind of... a frilly sort of effect with the little sides of the snowflake. So all just carry on adding them like that. And don't worry too much about it being on the end. As long as you press down, the glue will sort of mould itself around the side so it won't come off. And then finally, all we do, again, some of those iridescent gems and pop them in the centre. You're going to get that lovely sparkle. As I say, carry on right the way around and you're finished.
Well, if you've been inspired by Becky's project today and want to have a go at upcycling yourself, then we'd love to see your creations. Drop us an email at tv@docrafts.com because we'd love to see everything you make, and hopefully this really has inspired you to get out there and use something that you wouldn't have ever thought of using and making something beautiful. So until next time, happy crafting.